Hey random people, Random Attack here. Welcome to my channel. I'm gonna be playing a lot of video games on here, so if you like that kind of thing, please hit the subscribe button. And without further ado, let's jump into some Gwent. Right guys, so this is my Gwent account. I achieved rank 19 last season. I was 4.2k, so I should be able to play the new rank ladder that is coming out. I'm very excited for that. That's gonna be coming out this week, so there's gonna be more videos following that. I have built a simple deck that I want to try out in ranked, but oh, we have some ore. Let's buy a keg first.
See what we get. In shop, soup in shop.
Everyone likes keg openings, right? One keg opening. We'll probably get another one. But I tell them. Ooh. Hello. That was a good kick. Okay, so anyways, I will build a deck with that later on. So I will show you off what deck I have now. I've called it light and heavy because we have the light done banana cavalry and the heavy done banana cavalry. So the idea of this deck is basically to give them points, give them a bit of leeway using tower. And low point plays, and then capitalize on that by pulling these guys out of the deck. We have some river scouts as well to pull out more units. So we have teched one sergeant, but I don't know if that's necessary. I could switch this guy for another scout. That's probably a good idea. And on the gold side, we have Shani, which is pretty much out to include. When you're running these guys, we have John Natalis, which is really, really good now that you can filter to your deck. I have three cards that I can play with him, three tactic cards. I have Kira Metz because she can apply a Thunderbolt potion. I don't run Thunderbolt potions because I don't run tutors. So she can apply the Thunderbolt potion to these guys and give them back the armor so they can start buffing again. And I'm running DJ extra because, well, he's broken. Bronze side, I think it's pretty self-explanatory. I want to stack a row, hopefully the front row. But if not, then we can always build this row with the Commander's Horn. We have reinforcement to pull out Neneke because we can get those guys back in the deck and pull them out again. Or get something back and pull out with River Scout if all of them are dead. So just a bit of extra utility, but without further ado, oh yeah, and I'm playing Radovid because, well, he's really good now. He just provides a lot of utility and a lot of control to a deck that is pretty much uninteractive with the other side of the board. You don't really do anything to their side of the board, you just buff up your stuff. So let's take this for a spin.
Nothing like
this is the first time I'm playing this deck, so I don't know how it's gonna go.
To the dungeon with him.
Okay, so we want those guys back in the deck for sure. I just want to see. I have three goals, that's good, and Stannis. So we're gonna put one of them back. Right, we have two of our special cards with Ricky Bull with him, so I think we want to get one back. Decoy is pretty good on Stannis, so I think I'll just keep that and throw away this. Oh, five golds. That's a good start. So we're playing against dwarves, which is good because we have a lock. We're not running a lock, but this guy can lock two units, so that's good. I think we're just gonna open up with this guy.
Troops, here now!
See how he responds.
If my coins rank to ye, go kiss. Is he playing a
combo deck? Okay. Okay. Well, I think we just pull another one of those guys out.
But we're broke as shit peddlers.
Long live the king!
See how he responds to this. We lost the coin flip, but we can get a lot of tempo with that guy.
As a poison.
What is he running? I've got no idea, but we're just gonna do this.
Let's give up now.
Okay, that's fair. I don't know if we want to bleed him next round, as he is obviously playing dwarves. I want to get tower out. Oh, that's bad. That's really bad. Unfortunately, this cannot pull out tower anymore. Used to be able to. So, what's our best play here? Do we straight up pass? Or do we keep playing? That's 28 cards. He's mad. Alright, just straight up pass. Worst come to worst, we just draw one of the light cavalry guys. That's not bad. I don't want to use Tannis before I've enabled them, so.
Dwarf.
Not bad. So we got back card advantage. Technically, we are going first. Oh, sorry, we're going second now. Let's put Commander's Horn back in.
Peace with humans, and by that.
Okay, that's good. So we want to do a low tempo play. So that. Am I actually playing this on its own? Yeah, I think I am. I'm gonna bet that he's not playing Marigold Hailstorms and just stack this row so that I can Commander's Horn it.
Got a hearty hankering for Gwent.
Okay. I think we play this now. Can we pull a scout?
I told you so, you idiot!
Long live
Exodus. They're just gonna keep buffing themselves now. I'm just trying to do the lowest tempo play I can do. That's good. So this is gonna... I can't kill that, that's sad. I think I need to lock it, but then I'm not enabling my light cavalry coming out. Shut up, guy. I think we just play Shani here. Do we? No, I think we'll lock it.
Checkmate.
That is the best we could do now. Unfortunately, we're most likely not gonna pull
humans
out.
Humans are not to be trusted.
Ooh. Hello. Okay, that's good, because that's not gonna start hitting this and that's gonna get buffed, so that's fine. I think I really don't wanna play Dijkstra. Oh my god. What do I play? I think we have to Shani here. We just have to Shani.
I'm a medic. I tend to know what I'm doing when I prescribe something.
Do we get another one of those guys? No, because we need neighbors for...
Stand and fight.
We need neighbors for the heavy cavalry. Oh, that's really good. But it's also fine. Because we can just do this. I kind of want to make the lower value play. I'm still hoping on getting my... Oh, actually, wait. She's a 3. We could have killed so much with the epidemic. Get back down on those guys. It's fine because I'm gonna boost next turn.
Very afraid.
Hello there.
I am sadness.
These are aligned to an Igni so perfectly. I really hope he doesn't have an Igni. But I could not let him get the power boost of that. Actually, I should have. Why did I do that? I should have let him get the power boost of that.
Who taught you to play like this?
My mama.
Fuck Edwin!
Okay, so now this guy's gonna take the heat.
Never had your kneecaps broken.
Why would you do that? I think we might as well play Dijkstra. We play Dijkstra here. No, we play John Natalis.
Temeria has yet to speak its last.
Get the horn up. I'm most likely winning this anyway, even though I misplayed really, really badly. But he's got a lot of choices because he has a 40 card deck. Who does that? Okay. Well, that's not bad. Pieces. Let's take Stannis. I knew it. It was gonna happen. It was just gonna happen. No, he knows. Why is he buffing her? Right, we're just playing the DJ here. I don't want to give him Commander's Horn of Battle, so I want to play it again. That's fine.
Alert to arms!
Well, they're helping, right?
You'll be fine.
Ooh, there's the Commander's Horn. Could have resurrected my... Well, he couldn't have killed it though. Okay, so we take this game, even though we misplayed, we still take it. I promise I'll play better next game, I really do. Right, what do we get? Scraps, good, and 51 points. Right, let's take this for another spin. That was so bad. I should have just let him. I should have let him get points.
I've had men killed for less.
My Stannis would have been so much better after that. Wow. Okay, so we basically have no choice of what we're gonna mulligan. That's bad, because, yeah. It's fine, we can mulligan one of them in the next round. We go first, which is good. We can spy here.
Who takes an interest in cobblers? No one.
Of course we're gonna get Stannis. Go going first, I think most of the time you want to spy with this deck. Because if they do more than 9 points value play. Not a 9 points value play, but decent. Just gonna play this. So obviously he's playing the... What's the 7 strength card? I forgot the name of it. The guy that buffs. The 7 strength guy that buffs. Playing that, I think we can win. We have a lot of points. That's good. There's a cavalry. And now I think we simply block. Oh. Right, let's see what he's doing. That's not good. He's playing Warcry, and that's not good at all. But I think we want to commit to this round anyway. If he passes, we can take it with one card, so it's fine. There's a chance he might have Igni, so I'm gonna put this guy over here, so it buffs that guy twice. Ooh, hello. I think I'm just gonna do that.
I killed for less.
So we're ahead, which is good. I like that that's regressing now. It was so broken when it was not. And he passes. Sweet. So we're on even cards. We took the round. So the light cavalry did the job. So now the heavy cavalry has to carry. Our deck is thinned, which is really, really good. That's a good draw as well. And that's a really good draw. So now I think we put the commander's horn back in. We don't really want that. So we have one elite, which we can pull with the river scout. And we have one elect. Question is, do we want to go into the next round? As he's playing Skellige, I think we want to bleed him out a bit. The reason is that he has veteran. And I don't want his stuff buffing up. So, we're just gonna start off with a little Redanian Knight. Elite. Same shit.
Perfect.
Ooh. At the start of your turn, strengthen by 2. Right, I think what we do here is we do this. Or we can do it next turn. I want to be ahead to have the option to pass next turn. But I am going to do that. I want to have the option to pass next turn, right? So that puts me ahead by a lot. So it's most likely he's not going to overcome me with one card. There it is. Now we just pass. So what is he playing? Is he playing Axeman? It doesn't look like Axeman. Is he just playing like a random mishmash of bullshit? This rank, man. This rank is like... You have no idea what you're playing against until the end, basically. That's good. It's 2 of his golds down. We still got 3 in our deck though, which is bad. I really want to join one of them. Okay, so he takes the card down and he has to play first next turn, which is really good. There's no way we're playing in the Ragnarok. There's just no way. Good draw. I think we just keep this hand. Ugh. But I do want my golds though. I think we drop Nanaki. That's better. Because we can pull Radiant Elite from that. Right, we can log that. That's good. Right, so we need to roll stack here. Where are we gonna roll stack? I say we roll stack the middle. He's obviously, he might be playing Drought. We still not seen one. Did he throw away his... What is his plan? His Iris and Triss. Mulligan that. Okay. But we start off with this. On the middle row.
Long live the king!
Uncrate! That was obvious. So I think we just... Just log those two. I don't want that game huge. What are our options? We don't have a lot. See, that's the problem with this deck. You can't really interact with the other side. I was thinking of taking in a Thunder, and that would have helped a lot. But I think here we just do this. We have enough units. I'm not gonna stack this on the same row. If he has a lock, then he's welcome to play it. That's fine with us. Play this guy out here. Still not use his leader ability. I wonder what he's gonna pull out with it. Interesting. Come on, guy, play your cards. It's really good that we're two cards ahead as well. Can help a lot. Okay. Question is, can we deal with this? And I think the answer is no. So we just have to make more points than him. We can play decoy on Stannis. I think we need to go for this play.
You one of us or not? Long live it, etc.
He doesn't have a lot of turns to buff. Oh. Right, so he has a war cry. Right, so
cunning play.
We can now play Stannis.
I am not afraid.
That was dumb.
You one of us or not?
That was really dumb.
novice mistake.
It was a novice mistake, actually. Yeah, you're correct. But I have armor here, right? Armor's gonna help a lot. So we can decoy this guy later.
For the king!
So that's taking the hits from this row, and that's taking the hits from this row. We can decoy this later. It's gonna pull out Nanaki, which is just gonna be for sheer power. Again, I don't get this. What is he doing? So we can take the Stannis next turn, but we need the armor. So we decoy him now.
You stand before Royal Majesty.
The question is, do we want to get something back? If we get this back in our deck, we can play it again. But I don't think it's worth it. Commander's Horn is better value. Anyway, we're just gonna get these guys back in case he actually like takes the lead somehow. I don't think it's possible, but maybe he does.
Mordron Freyr is patient, but she brooks no insult.
Right, I think that's game. There's no way he takes it. We just win. I have no idea what his deck is. Not even gonna show him what I have. GG. Hi guys, so this is how the deck works. I hope you enjoyed the games. I misplayed a lot. I'm sorry about that. I'm rusty. I just got back from work. I've not played. This is literally my warm-up games. I will try and be on form next time. Please hit the subscribe button. It's gonna help me a lot. And I'll see you next time.